What's good, everybody, and thanks for dropping in for this segment of The Matrix with your boy Prime. It's been a long time. I know y'all been like, well, when I'm going to actually start doing actual videos back on my channel. Well, I'm starting to do it, but, you know, with everything going with the NLVC, you know, I've been doing everything with the team. But no longer the wait, I am officially here to give y'all a little bit of something heads on from your boy. All right, well, I hope everybody had a lovely Christmas. Everybody got what they, you know, people had a good time with their families. Everyone, you know, just had a great time. I know everybody's still on their break. Everybody's still having, you know, relaxation time and doing the do. But you know what this is about. Your boy Prime going to do it live style. Prime style. So let's get to the point at hand of the video so we can go ahead. Now, I'm going to talk about some of the things that, now this is going to be addressed to the devs. Just want to let everybody know, until by the time they actually get this video, you know, because I want to, you know, don't necessarily want to bug them at the present moment, you know, because I know they're spending time with their families, the new year is coming up. So, you know, I'm just giving a little bit of things that's a little bit out there, that's a little bit early. So now we have been through the transition ever since release date. There's been a lot of things that have been going on. There's been a lot of negative feedback. There's been positive feedback. There's been people that have been really, they've been doing predetermined actions. Then they go ahead and they get the game. They see that the game is actually a good product. It's a good game. And they realize it does need a little bit more improvement. Needs a little bit more polish. We've been through, you know, price drops. We've been through demos. I mean, it's been through a lot of stuff through this process. But we know that the dev team is doing everything that they possibly can to provide us, you know, provide the community, you know, primarily the casual gamer and, you know, the hardcore sim gamer, a very, very good NBA Live experience. And actually, we got that. But there's a little bit of things that I want to discuss that needs to be actually tweet a little bit more that we need to do. So right after patch 1.4, 1.4, which is patch 2, which was a major patch and the one that we had officially got, the game has significantly played a lot better when we had addressed this. And a lot of individuals at Christmas time, they actually got NBA Live. So we see that the online status has spiked, so that's a good thing. So we've been seeing that, and a lot of individuals been playing it. So what I want to address on this is to let everybody know is that, you know, it's going to be some type of frustration on certain aspects of the game, but there's going to be a lot of good points that you're going to see as well. So, you know, the Ultimate Team, the NBA Live Ultimate Team, that's a very, very good experience. Now, basically myself, I just recently started getting into that and I've been playing it and I enjoy it. I actually really enjoy it. A former teammate of mine, Izzy Snow, some of the members of the NBA Live stream team, members I used to, that I used to be with, before I went on to other ventures, when I was with them or whatever, they used to talk about it a lot. So, you know, I said, you know, and a lot of people in the community as well, you know, they actually, they wanted me to really get into the LUT. So I started doing it and I actually enjoy it. It's a really, really fun mode. It is a really, really, really fun mode. Now I see the reason why a lot of people enjoy playing it, and I really enjoy playing it. And the good thing about it is that not only that you can make your custom team and buy everything, you can actually play a head-to-head game and your record can actually be recorded, and you can also have competition with those teams and have an excellent time. That's a good thing. So I have been enjoying that. But for the real, real hardcore gamers with the actual teams, this is one thing I want to address to the dev team with that. Okay. I can't stress it enough, and I did announce this on the committee episode 3. I did say that when it comes down to the head-to-head, okay, you have to go ahead and put in a sequence. Well, not a sequence. You have to put in an option where you can actually do a manual substitution, and you can also, or you can do the auto substitution. Right now, it's just strictly on auto. I mean, you can manually do it, but the computer is going to override your commands, and that is not real good for individuals that like to do their own substitutions and do it for themselves and look over what they want to do, because you don't want to have no mishaps. I understand your direction of what you're trying to do to try to make the game faster, but there are some individuals that really, really, really are, they really have a sim mind, to the opposed of the casual gamer where they just want to get in and they just want to play. It's nothing wrong with the casual gamer, just that sometimes the casual gamer, they are a little bit rewarded on certain things where they don't need to be rewarded on, where they have to, you know, and get their game, you get their game up and get their basketball knowledge a little bit, you know, up to, you know, up to par. So on that, I understand you want to have the game to be fun at the same time, but so at the same time, there's going to be a lot more high basketball IQ individuals and a lot more sim minded guys, which is, you know, the high basketball and sim guys such as myself, to that's going to be able to play the game. So now as y'all watching the video and what you're seeing and what I'm showing here is that now this game I played, one of the I was just playing the guy, and at the moment on this game I actually won this game. But the thing about it was that I need them to really address is that then there's some sequences where the rebounding has been drastically improved. They have to really, really improve the rebounding, because there's a lot of over the backs, there's a lot of warping, and then, you know, there's a lot of things where the guy doesn't have to go to the rebound. So you have to really, really critique and have to really, really enhance the rebounding. Fouls need to be up a little bit more in the game, Dev Team. I mean, the fouls need to be addressed. I mean, I understand y'all did a lot of other things that's within the paint area, which will actually, that'll be another discussion for another day. I'm not trying to get into that. But I'm just saying this before patch 3 actually comes upon us, because we know that patch 3 is going to be upon us. It will be coming. You know, that is my main key when it comes down to that, knowing that patch 3 is going to be coming. And with patch 3 coming, you know, I know there's going to be the remaining face scans. It could be some up-to-dates. But if you're going to add anything for, you know, gameplay, and I did talk to, one of the devs. And hopefully that the gameplay is going to be something that you're going to address as well from the patch 2 and add an additional gameplay enhancements and improvements. But like I say again, some of the animations and some of the dribble animations and some of the movements are a little bit erratic. Okay, there are certain times where you can't deal with it, but most of the time there's something that you can obviously you can tolerate. But on the, you know, a competition standpoint, it does be frustrating, because, you know, that can alter the game in a lot of ways. So some of the animation movements and the rebounding, and that's the main thing. And there is one sequence that needs to be abolished from everything as a whole. Me and the NBA Live Vet Committee, we're going to talk about that a little bit more. It's that sequence on offense where a lot of individuals, they try to force their way, bore themselves, just try to maul themselves in the paint. And that means that the defense really can't do anything, knowing that you already know what your opponent is trying to do. So it's not like that the certain things are not respected. Sometimes it works, but sometimes it don't. So, you know, that needs to be addressed, and that has to get, that really, really needs to get done. But all in all, as a whole, everybody, NBA Live 16 is a very, very good game. It is not a bad game and whatsoever. It's very, very good. I've been addressing that. Everybody that's in the community that's been addressing that. So we just want y'all to go ahead and pick up your copy. To my knowledge, if it is still active, I know NBA Live was for $19.99. I know on Xbox Live it was going for $16. So y'all should be able to go ahead and just try it out and go ahead and go to your nearest, retailer and go pick it up. Y'all have nothing to lose and y'all have a very, very good time. There's a lot of options that's in here. You know, it's the ultimate team. It's a very, very good option. I just started playing it. Of course, the Pro-Am, that's very, very excellent with all the additions and everything that's actually being put into the game. So I'm not trying to sell y'all on the game. I'm just letting you know my virtual opinion, and y'all feel that I'm going to be biased. I'm not. I know that NBA Live 2K is still the better overall game, but NBA Live 16 is not bad, no way, no how. It's just that NBA Live has always been my preference, and it's always going to be that. So I never denied saying that 2K wasn't a better game as an overhaul because of the sim experience. I don't play at all like that, so I play live. So y'all, people that know me and already know my resume and what it is, where I, you know, what I stand for, that's what it's about. So all I can say, people, is that, you know, just go ahead and pick up your copy anytime, and then you go from there. Also,
hell no.
There's a lot of things that's actually been going on with the, a lot of people been asking me, you know, what do I feel about where does NBA Live go from here? Well, NBA Live is going to stay, people. It's not going anywhere. So there's no reason why a lot of y'all individuals that's out there, y'all just been downing Live or whatever like that. But we know the reason why people do that. We're not going to get into that conversation. Me and the NBA Live Vet Committee had touched on those points. I'm not going to get onto those points. Just know that we absolutely know the reason why people bash NBA Live, and the reason why people do that. So, you know, and like I said, it's going to be an uphill battle, but really it's not going to be as hard as you think it will be, individuals out there. So please, y'all just have to, you know, just know that it's going to be an uphill battle. And all the ones that's out there that are hating just to be hating for no reason, where y'all just want to bash for no reason, please play the game, do your homework first, and make sure that you have a very, very good approach instead of predetermining what it is that you play. Because majority of you individuals out there, that I know this for a fact, y'all only played the demo, and the demo does not have none of the new features, will not have any of the updates with the actual game. So now I think on EA Access, if you have an Xbox One, you can get NBA Live 16 now. I think it's for free right now. I'm not sure. Don't quote me on that because I haven't checked. I think it is. I'm not sure. Don't quote me on that. I haven't checked. So I'm just laying it out there. So again, I'm saying this again. I say maybe it may be free for you to play NBA Live 16 on EA Access, but I'm not sure because I haven't checked. With all the price drops and everything and all the promotions and everything that been going on, I haven't checked. I don't know too much about the PlayStation 4 version. I really don't know what actually has been provided. So, you know, I know y'all still have the demo, but I don't know about anything else.
And I'm about to close up shop on this video. And so y'all can actually watch the rest of this game. But as y'all watching this game, what I want y'all to do is that I want y'all to pinpoint some of the things that I'm complaining about, because I know y'all hear me in the background. I didn't edit this video. I want y'all to see in game exactly what it is what I was complaining about as I was playing it. Okay, so make sure y'all like the video. Make sure you put your comments down, and you go from there. And as y'all watching the game, people, this is just one of those games where it was just a lot of issues going on in the game. And it was just like real erratic and real crazy in the game. It was just one of those games. Because like I say, when you play head to head and you play an actual online ranked match, not just on the LUT, but just on the actual, you know, the real, you know, in the in the matching lobby, and you playing, you got to remember, when you play against an actual human being, that's where you find out all the issues and the problems when you actually play another human. Okay, so y'all have to really take that into consideration. That's where you find out all the stuff and how the game actually plays when you play another person. Not so much when you play the computer, but when you play an actual human being. And that's when all the issues, or when you see a lot of stuff that goes on in the game. Okay, well, everything will be in the description below. Just make sure y'all finish watching the game and enjoy. And I know y'all going to hear a lot of my complaining about everything, but y'all will see the reason why I was complaining and why I was getting a little bit upset and a little bit mad with it. And I know y'all going to enjoy and crack up and laugh about it. I know I have. So, all right, y'all, but they're legit. So everything that I'm saying is legit on that issue and what's going on. So, again, people, enjoy the game and go from there. All right, y'all, I'm Ghost.
Sometimes the simplest plays are the hardest ones to execute. Good layup.
Steph Curry's been the MVP candidate, but Klay Thompson, sometimes he gets overshadowed on how many things he does for this team, Jeff.
You can make a strong argument that Klay Thompson is the best two guard in the league when you factor in his defensive ability. He is so improved defensively from when he first came into the league to now. He can guard point guard. We've seen him match up in the playoffs with Chris Paul. You can see him taking threes. He can lock down twos. I don't think Klay Thompson
will
ever get his just due because defense is far too often overlooked.
Three-point attempt.
Yeah, why not take it?
It's a loose ball.
What?
Green against Miritich.
What?
What a dump.
Hey, sometimes
yeah, this is my last game.
Beats good defense.
I can't play this shit.
Ashamed with on that possession. That was a well-defended, well-contested shot.
To the basket. It's good. A two-pointer. And Doug McDermott, 18 points. He's got the room.
Yeah, they got these motherfuckers just keep on crashing the paint. They got to fix this. They need a patch. This passion fucked up the goddamn defense in the game.
The rim.
Get the rebound. Yeah, it done fixed. It done messed up. It's like they ran away.
Jeff, we spoke earlier.
Why are you running away?
Reminds you a little bit like Scottie Pippen playing under the shadow of Jordan or James Worthy under the shadow of Magic.
Are you kidding, Mike? Did you just compare Steph Curry to Michael Jordan and Magic?
Oh, what a play. He threw it right back down.
Basketball's a game of runs. And this game has been no exception. It's been back and forth, and it's giving the fans the kind of up and
oh
down.
Oh my God,
and forth
man. This shit, man.
That keeps them interested.
For the layup, puts it in. Chicago's shooting 56% from the field tonight. On the drive, nearly a foul called against the Bulls. It's only their first foul in the last 2 minutes, but the next one and they'll be in the penalty.
Great effort by the defender trying to slide over and take the big time charge.
Get the fuck out of here
because he was just a count late.
4 minutes gone by in the third. Chicago's
man, they got this stuff playing so erratic, it's ridiculous. Online, this stuff is playing erratic. And when I mean it's playing erratic, it's like animations are so damn bad. It's like, look at that.
Livingston for two, off balance.
What?
His jump shot won't go. The Warriors with the offensive rebound for a second chance.
Oh my God. I should have had that rebound a long time ago. See all that stuff in the paint.
Snell against Bogut. To the basket, flips it up. And Tony Snell with the bucket. Whistle blows. It's going to be a quick timeout here. 20 seconds.
Oh, this is some bullshit.
You're not going to see a better possession in the NBA from both sides of the ball. Good defense, good offense. Good offense won out that time.
Oh, what?
In the paint, and Andre Iguodala with
the I don't even want to play this shit no more. Because this is ridiculous. Because this is ridiculous, man. This, though, I don't know what the fuck is wrong with these anime. And why they keep on going and keep on having their ass in the fucking paint. They got everybody all smashed in the paint instead of picking up their man.
ESPN and EA Sports after this. Fourth quarter set to begin. Can they possibly keep this pace up? What an offensive display.
Both teams have been offensive juggernauts so far in this game. And yes, if they
this is ridiculous.
A great opportunity to keep scoring the ball the way they have been. Stops are critical, though, to try to win this game down the stretch.
Whistle sounds out of bounds, so it'll be Bulls ball.
Gibson's rejected. Gets to the rim. Can hit.
Why the fuck is Barstow in the damn game?
Throws it down. This has turned out to be one of the better.
Why are you in the game?
Mike, they're really getting after each other on both sides of the floor. Throws it. The alley-oop finishes with a slam. A look at the athleticism exploding up to finish.
Oh, get the fuck out of here. This is getting ridiculous. He's just throwing it up and it's going in.
14 points in this matchup. These teams are just lighting it up.
But then Taj Gibson missed a bunny.
With all kinds of offensive aggression.
What the fuck is y'all doing?
It's all about making...
These animations is fucking horrible.
To make them better is to give up. Oh, and he throws it down. Oh, that's a sweet finish right there.
Whoa!
Hey, your first priority as a defense is to force them to shoot jump shots. When there's a drive, there's got to be help and make them kick the ball out to the perimeter and then close out. Thompson. As the double team close in, whistle blows, an intentional foul. Coach going to make some changes and switch up the matchups. From three-point land, bang! What a shot!
What the fuck is going on?
That's a thing of beauty right there. The three-point shot, nothing but net. Oh, the catch and finish! In close games, you cannot allow the dribble to break you down and get right to the basket. The individual defender has to do a good job, but the help defense is late as well. From beyond the arc, puts it in. 1 point game. For two, it's good.
They're making Golden State. This is ridiculous. Yeah, this is not fun. This is not fun at all.
Strong to the goal. Gets it to go. Nice play from Pau Gasol. Oh, he steps out of bounds. You want to keep attacking.
Because this is not right at all. I don't know what the hell they done did to this game, but they did not play. Now it's playing horrible.
Throws the alley-oop. Throws it down. What a pass. It sure was right on target, up in the air. A full-fledged flush. And they call timeout.
It was really messing up. I see it right now. I'm pressing buttons, and this game is really messing up.
The two defenders converge to the rim. Can't get the layup to fall. Attack.
There is no way.
2 points. That's just a nice layup right there. Here's the lob. And he lays it in. Gorgeous feed. And a great catch. Sometimes we overlook how difficult that catch is. Gets into the paint.
Oh, my God. He pushed me right back, man. I tried to get...
After the basket was open, drive down, and finish it with no one in sight. Inside. Can't get the layup to go. Block.
Where's the fucking foul at?
To protect the basket. Hey, even though they missed that shot, that defense is not good enough. You've got to protect the basket and protect the paint. And Jimmy Butler's whistled for the foul.
That ain't no charge. That ain't no damn charge. Man, I'm not playing this shit no more. They need to really dramatically do an overhaul on this.
Livingston.
Because this is terrible. This is fucking horrible.
Move gets inside. Plenty of contact. Offensive foul called against Livingston. Three and a half gone by in the fourth. The Bulls down by one. Out of bounds.
Why is it taking him so fucking long to pass the goddamn ball?
Gets to the rim. 2 points. Gorgeous play from Pau Gasol. You want excitement? You want to see a game go back and forth where the lead changes off.
Oh, this is getting ridiculous.
You have that here tonight. This is one fascinating game. Gets it, throws it down. What a play. Oh, that's nice right there. The finish at the rim with the nice dunk.
Curling in. On the drive. Great offensive rebound. Thrown away.
That kind of play, Mike.
Yeah, that's why I had to put no in there. Because I need to get another shot blocker in there.
Hey, that's good, smart basketball. You're down in the fourth quarter late, and you're not in the penalty. Get aggressive defensively. Try to get a steal. And even if you...
And he puts it down.
This is just ridiculous defense right here. Giving up uncontested dunks. That is sad. Sad.
Let's it fly. Iguodala's two-pointer won't go. And there's the foul. They had to stop that clock.
Up three with a minute to go, shooting two free throws. It's imperative that you make at least one free throw to make
you
it.
You see all the flaws in this game right now. Look at that. I saw the Jokic. I seen so much stuff in this game.
Curry against Rose. Inside to the
wow, and he just went right through nowhere.
That's nice body control right there on that layup. Good finish.
Chicago's leading Golden State by a score of 79.
That's a horrible call.
There's the double team. Oh, pretty move into the paint. To the basket. Oh, a shot. Puts it down. What a play. To the rim. Offensive rebound.
How in the fuck did he get that? And why is everybody on defense playing stupid?
For the foul, they had to do it to stop the clock.
They're in an enviable position right now. Up one, two free throws. You make them both, you give yourself a three-point lead, and you just have to defend the three-point line at the other end of the floor.
He hits two free throws, so they extend the lead to three. And Golden State calls timeout as time is running down. Thompson, and here's the double. From downtown. There's the horn, and that's the game as they defeat the Warriors.
I got my win, I'm done.
To 80. This has been a presentation.
Here we go with the EA Sports
whatsoever. They gotta fix this shit.
The Bulls.
This is not acceptable. I don't even want to see the stats. I don't even want to see them. That is not acceptable. It is not acceptable at all. They gotta fix a lot of stuff in here. That, I don't know, the patch did some good things, but now that I'm playing it on the head-to-head, and I'm playing it a lot more, it looked like that it just messed it up even more. You know what I mean? Yeah, they missing shots, but they made the animation so they erratic. I'm talking about they so erratic, it's ridiculous.
Well, I hope y'all enjoyed the game. I want to... Y'all pinpoint on certain things that y'all actually saw. I know y'all was hearing me complain in the background. So if you know, you know. But if you did know, your boy Brian brought it to you. I hope y'all enjoyed the game. And make sure you rate, comment, and subscribe. All right, y'all. I'm Ghost. Peace.